We have Krishna now, who's called in from Chennai. Krishna, what is your question?
I have two questions. One is that I recently paid a 10% advance for a villa project.
Mm-hmm.
And subsequently, I came to know that the project, there is a water locking is happening. So I did not sign any agreement with the builder as such, because the agreement time is 2 months from that time, and that is coming very close now. And now I want to go and cancel my advance, cancel my application, and I want him to pay the full money back. So he's saying that a lot of presentations I sent wherein it was mentioned that we'll pay the money back to you only after we find some other buyer to take that plot. And also that, okay, it may take cancellation charges also, they'll deduct to the extent of 5% of the total project value.
Mm-hmm.
Since I have not signed any agreement, is it he's right in deducting and keeping me waiting for a couple of months more? That is my first question.
Right. Krishna, two questions. Do you have a receipt for this money that you paid him?
Yes, of course I have.
Okay. And also this, you know, you say you mentioned that you went ahead and you spoke to the developer and asked him for a refund, etc. Now, was this done in writing or was this just an oral conversation?
I spoke to him over phone. Then he sent me, requested me to send a mail. I sent a mail to him, that is what I want to cancel. So over phone, he was telling me that it will take a couple of months more to get the money to you, and there will be at least 50% of the money what you pay will be the cancellation charges.
So Vinay, the developers asked him to...
an agreement as such, yeah.
Right. Vinay, the developers smartly asked him to send a mail saying that he wants to cancel the agreement, but has reverted on the phone, over the phone.
Krishna, I have a question to ask of you. You said that you want to withdraw from the project because there's some water logging. What exactly is happening there?
See, what happened is I'm new to the Chennai. So after I implemented, I paid the advance, I inquired with a couple of the people. And they mentioned last year when there were heavy floods in Chennai, and they complete that project is submerged. So they said, don't even book in that place. So that's where I came to know that I need to come out of the project.
Okay, see, if there is a defect in the particular plot or the entire layout, then you actually have a much better case, because if there is a defect, then he's bound to tell you about the particular defect at the time of booking. Now, I'm not very sure whether this is an actual defect or it is just a temporary thing. So you can investigate that. If there's a defect, then that should be your ground, that you were not informed that this place is prone to waterlogging, or there might even be some kind of a water body below it. It does happen. So if these things have not been told to you, that is your best bet. If you send him a mail saying, I wish to withdraw, then he's going to make you hold on. And he's not going to make you hold on for 2 months. It's going to be many months. That much I can guarantee you. So if you want to get out of this, use whatever you can. If there was certain defects not made known to you, use that. And try to get as much as your money out of this project and leave. That would be my advice to you.
So essentially, Krishna, you need to do some, basically evidence gathering over here, which will show that the developer actually did not tell you about the defect or the fact that there is a water body present which flooded that that particular project or whatever. You need to do all of that and then approach the court. The other thing, of course, is that if the developer is giving you a response on the phone, be very clear and tell the developer that if I have emailed something, I expect a response by email. Ask for everything in writing, because that will help you in the court of law, which is very important considering that he doesn't have an agreement. What do you say, Vinay?
Absolutely. See, we always advise that when you pay money, you must enter into some form of agreement and register it, because that is what will ensure that rights and liabilities of both the parties are, spelt out in black and white. Now, when there is nothing and it's verbal, the builder naturally will twist it to suit his own purposes. So it's not a good idea to give money without an agreement.
Right. So those are two key takeaways coming in on Property Hotline. One, if you pay the builder money, any amount of money, it could be just 1 rupee. But if you are paying the developer money, insist on an agreement. One. The other thing is, of course, that you have to register the agreement. And thirdly, do not indulge in verbal conversations with developers. Ask for everything in writing. Communicate in writing with the developer and ask for an answer, a reply in over email, or ideally in black and white in a letter.
You can watch live TV on our website mpnow.in. Find us on Facebook at facebook.com/magicbricksnow. And don't forget to click the like button. You can also follow us on Twitter at magicbricksnow. To stay updated with all our programming, hit the subscribe button on our YouTube channel by logging on to youtube.com/magicbricksnow.